I was here about 2 weeks ago to get my oil changed, and he told me that I need to get my tires changed. Three tires only, because one of them I had to get. I got changed not too long ago because I had a flat tire. So I just told I got. It's gonna take about an hour and a half to 2 hours. So I came prepared. I'm gonna go for a run. Not fitting in the bathroom. Whoa! Over the toilet. This ain't no over the toilet. What kind of toilet is going over?
I mean, she could.
I spent 2 hours building this.
And
So this past weekend we celebrated our 3-year anniversary, and it's just kind of crazy to think that it's already been 3 years. Cause I mean, I know I'll probably see this every year. But it feels like we just celebrated our first year. But time is flying. We're about to have a kid. So we wanted to have a nice little celebration this year, especially since last year we didn't really get to do anything. And this would be the last one before we have a kid slash kids, but the pandemic and stuff. So we kept it low-key this year. We just had dinner at One Mon Grill, which has been my choice for my birthday dinners, but it was closed earlier this year. We pretty much get the same thing every time. We start off with the spinach artichoke dip, and then we share two steaks. One, the first one is a prime rib that comes with this amazing house horseradish sauce, and then my favorite, which is the Hawaiian ribeye. But they got rid of the prime rib for some reason, man. So we had to settle for the New York strip, which just wasn't as good. But I mean, at least they had my favorite, the Hawaiian ribeye. That basically is just like a big chunk of kalbi. And that's basically all that we did. But I remember that I have footage from our first anniversary that I just never got around to editing. So I decided just to throw that in now. And we did a little Q&A on Instagram on a drive up. And I'll be including the replies throughout the video.
Alright guys, this is Friday, October 5th, 2018. Hey, I'm talking!
I were to give a superpower to Jian, it would have to be teleportation. Like, she could just blink and be somewhere that she needs or wants to be. Because she's always late.
Speed. Being super fast with everything. Because he could help out with chores and he could do it in a speedy manner. I wouldn't say play is my favorite thing to do as a date. It's just walking around. Occasionally we'll walk around like in our neighborhood, whether it was at our apartment or our current place. Just walk, and I personally enjoy that because it's just quality time where we could just, you know, hold hands and just talk and just share what's been going on or what's on our heart. So that's my favorite.
For me, it's like I like trying to find new places to eat, but then also like trying to find like a place that we can go to regularly where we're both genuinely just like enjoy, kind of make it our go-to spot.
Our Asia trip. We're gonna go this summer, and I feel like it's one of the biggest, it's probably the biggest trip that we'll probably go on together, especially as a married couple.
I think the one thing that I'm mainly looking forward to is obviously the vacation, because it's something that I've never done something like that before, and it's probably like, yeah, it's gonna be like the biggest vacation we'll have, and we'll have like the biggest we'll have in a long time. So I'm mad excited. I'm gonna eat a lot of food, so Definitely, that's like probably the biggest thing. I think just we've enjoyed being able to host countless like family and friends. That was really cool. But I think if it was just like one particular thing, it would have to be our being able to host like New Year's Eve, where we had just all our friends come together and be like usher in the new year together with friends. It's something that we've greatly enjoyed doing with others. Being able to go to our friend's house and whatnot, but us being able to do it like as hosts was very special to us and something that we really want to continue to do in the future.
I think just having our first place together, living together as a married couple, is probably one of my favorite things about our first year. I think we say this to each other all the time, but just sharing the love of Christ and being intentional about having a Christ-centered marriage. I think just like even as we were dating, that's just kind of what we've been preparing for.
Having a partner, someone that is your biggest supporter, someone that's always there with you by your side, whether you're sick, whether you're hurting, whether you're just not feeling well, when you're happy, you know, you get to experience all those things together and just grow together. It's just something special because it's just like a bond that you don't and cannot have anybody else.
Wow.
Say a little prayer, get your money, man. Life goes
though
on.
I'm that's hopeful, all. Yes, I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it, let it take you away.
Most difficult thing has to be, unsurprisingly, communication. You know, it's just like one of those things that you will continue to work on in marriage, and hopefully one day soon it'll get to a point where it's just like so easy. But I would say it's been challenging. It hasn't been. It's difficult at times, but I think when we just learn, we listen to each other and are able to grow, I think it's been very like rewarding, and it's just very like awesome to see how our relationship continues just to evolve.
Yeah, I would agree. I think just communication is probably one of the difficult things. I think in any relationship in general, but I think particularly in marriage, because we're always together and we have to make decisions together. On top of that, I think because it's hard to communicate sometimes, I think extending and showing grace to one another has been something that's been difficult. But again, we've grown a lot, and just remembering that God has loved us and He shows us grace every single day, therefore we should show each other grace, has been one of the biggest challenges, yet such a huge blessing.
But the most surprising thing that of our first year of marriage is just how particular she can be about certain things. Not a lot, but there are certain things like the shower, closing the shower curtain all the way, but not closing the drawer, like my clothes drawers all the way in. There are other things that I just really I can't think of right now. But there's very little things. It's just weird because like she's so not like that in general. Like that's not her personality. But then there are just like things at home that she's so particular about. It's like very weird because it's just not how she is normally, you know.
Since we've been married, I think for most of you guys who know Steve, he's not the most expressive, affectionate person, at least outwardly. But I think since we've been married, he's been more. I know it may not be obvious all the time, but I think especially when we're together and we're alone, he's just definitely been more affectionate, expressive, and I think that's something I really appreciate because my number one love language is words of affirmation. So I think he's been very intentional about that, which I'm very surprised, but in a very good way.
But one thing that Chien does all the time is, it's like, what is it called? A term of endearment. You know, like honey, baby, you know, it's like very like sweet, you know, and you hear you're like, oh, I have this connection with somebody. Mm-hmm. However, in the manner in which she uses it, it's not a very loving way. It is more so a very like directly in drilling into my ear. So this is my impression of her. Babe. Babe. Babe.
Wow. I do sound like that.
Babe. Babe. One thing that she does, there's a lot of things she says a lot over and over. And one of those things, besides the babe, is, wow, I haven't been here in a while. I haven't eaten this in a while.
All right.
That's
I do that. His Fortnite life, where he will be like, you know, come home, he's on his computer playing Fortnite, and he'll be like, what's up, my guy? All with his Fortnite crew. But every time he logs in or sees his like people ready to play Fortnite, he'll be like, what's up, my guy? Is that pretty accurate?
Yeah, it is.
Or like, he's like in the middle of the game and like he dies or something, or someone shoots him from a distance, he'll be like, no, no! I'm trash. Sorry guys. Oh my gosh, I'm trash. Again, I don't even know what that means, but I'll, in the background, I'm like, babe, don't say that. Like, I'm trash. Good morning, everybody. Happy Sunday. Today is October 7th, and it is our wedding anniversary. Today is our actual wedding anniversary. We started off our morning by going to church. We went to Renewal this morning. Went to their first service. It was really good. To be completely honest, I think we were kind of struggling because we were both kind of... I was struggling because I kind of was very sleepy, but my husband over here kept me accountable and was pinching me throughout service.
Right now we're at Reanimated Coffee. Reanimator? Coffee? I think it's coffee. We're in dire need of some caffeine. Philly and with Hopper, gotta get caffeine.
Intentional about spending time with each other because we see each other every day, but like being intentional and conscious of spending time doing things together.
Not so much now, but in the beginning when we first came here, it was just being adjusted to living with a guy. Just little things like sharing a bathroom with a guy or sharing a bed with another person.
Go to restaurant has to be Bao's Shanghai.
Bao's.
It's like our favorite place for sure.
What we usually order, I think our go-to order when we go to Bao's is definitely the soup dumplings. That's what they're known for. Their Szechuan string beans, their fried pork chop, their mapo tofu, spicy wontons, the general Bao's chicken. Greatest highlight of our first year will be Penny. I know we were not known to many of our friends' kids, but I think like just like in our immediate family, being an aunt and uncle has been just so amazing. We've spent so much time, like just since the moment Penny was born and just till now, like we've just spent so much time with Penny, and just seeing her growing up has been fascinating. It's been just such a blessing in our lives.
If you look at our photo albums, it's just on our phones, it's filled with just Penny, pictures of Penny. And as you can tell from the vlogs, like constantly filled with Penny. Just love and adore her. She's just like such a cute little baby, but also just like, I don't know, something special because we are like related to her. She has brought us, like our family, even closer, and how like our relationship with my sister and brother-in-law has continued to grow. Even more so with the birth of Penny has been a true blessing. So, kind of the lucky man. I prayed. And so we got set up on a blind date by Irene.
Irene is a very close sister of mine. At the time we attended the same church, but she is just an older sister, a spiritual mentor, and she's really walking with me just in faith, and we're still very, very close.
I met Irene about a month before I met Chiyun at a mutual friend's birthday party. So the very first thing that we did was share with each other our testimony and how we came to our faith. And then the next thing she asked me was if I was single and if I was interested in dating. But she had someone in mind, and later I found out that it was Chiyun.
And the rest is history.
And the rest is indeed history.
Now we're married.
So I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was fun.
Q&A,
a little Q&A. It was fun for us, and you know, maybe we'll do like an updated one in the future. I don't know. But before we end the whole video, we just wanted to give our little bit of wisdom that we've attained over the past year, and you know, pass it on, pay it forward for to you guys. Hopefully, you know, there's something that you guys can take with you.
I have three. My number one would be seek God first. Always putting God first before ourselves and each other. I think everything just kind of falls into place when you really seek God in your marriage. I would say number two would be communication. You know, when things are bothering you or you're upset or there's something that's on your mind, always just communicate. You can't assume the other person knows what's on your mind or what you're feeling. So I think just really being a good communicator in your marriage. And my number three would be intentional. I think being intentional in terms of just spending quality time with each other. I know, like, you know, as a married couple, you live with each other, but you can't assume like that's just enough.
I'll just keep it simple. Remember that you guys are on the same team. You guys are each other's best teammates. I know at times it'll seem like you guys are going against each other and you guys are each other's enemies, but just like as a good teammate, you know, there'll be times where you'll disagree and you'll have arguments, but to be a good teammate, you have to put your teammate first and just listen to them and hear them out and work together to achieve a common goal. When we do that, even in our worst moments, we're able to just grow and appreciate each other all the more. Your spouse is your teammate and the best one that you can ever have. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you for watching and supporting us. Continue to pray for us because
yes,
we definitely
please.
need it. And yeah, see y'all next time.
Bye. She's guiding my hand.